Hello, I'm Rick Wicklin from SAS. Today I'm talking about a new syntax for specifying and manipulating lists in the SAS IML language. The letters IML stand for Interactive Matrix Language. IML enables programmers to implement new algorithms in a high-level natural language that supports matrix vector computation and linear algebra. Matrices are very useful structures, but SAS IML 14.2 introduced new data structures, namely tables and lists. These enable you to pass collections of objects to and from functions. A new feature in SAS IML 14.3 is the ability to define and manipulate lists by using a natural syntax in the language. For the purpose of this talk, a list is similar to a dynamic array. You can store matrices, vectors, tables, even other lists. You can insert or delete items in any location of a list, and the size of the list will grow or shrink automatically. In this talk, I'm going to present four ways to create and manipulate lists by using a new syntax. The new list operators are the list creation operator, which uses square brackets, the list item operator, which uses a dollar sign, the list subset operator, which also uses square brackets, and the named item operator, which uses a pound sign or a hashtag symbol. Feature number one, you can create a list by enclosing items in square brackets. In previous releases, you could set or add one item at a time to a list, but now you can create a list by enclosing a comma-separated sequence of items within square brackets. For example, suppose you want to encapsulate related information about a patient in a clinical study. Well, you might want to specify the patient's name, Bob, the patient's age, 36, and several of the patient's cholesterol readings. In the program on this slide, P1 is a list that contains the three items, a string, a scalar number, and a vector. You can also create a list of lists. Perhaps Bob is not the only patient in your study. In the program on this slide, a list is created for each of three patients. Then, a list of lists, called patients, is created, which contains data about the three patients, Bob, Fred, and Tom. Feature number two, you can use the dollar sign operator to specify items in a list. For example, the age field is the second item in the list named P1. So P1 dollar sign 2 returns the patient's age. Similarly, the syntax patients dollar sign 1 returns the first patient in the list of patients. That patient is Bob. You can use the list item operator more than once. For example, the third statement on this slide shows how to extract the second item from the third patient in the list. Now, on the previous slide, the argument to the list item operator was a number, such as 1, 2, or 3. But you can also specify a variable that contains a number. This slide shows a loop that iterates over items in the patient's list. During each iteration, the name of the ith patient and the cholesterol values for the ith patient are extracted. The loop computes the average cholesterol value for each patient in the list. You can also use the list item operator on the left side of an assignment statement. If Bob's age is not really 36, but is actually 63, you can assign that value into the second item of Bob's list. Similarly, you can update items in a list of lists. Feature number three, you can extract a sublist by specifying the indices for the items that you wish to extract. You put the indices inside square brackets. Now, notice that the sublist operator always returns a list, even if you specify only one item. To get the item itself, instead of a list that contains one item, you should use the dollar sign operator. You can also use the sublist operator on the left-hand side of an assignment statement. Feature number four. You can use the pound sign or hashtag operator to name items in a list. A named list is sometimes called a map or an associative array. For the example of a list that contains patient data, it might be difficult to remember that the first item is the patient's name, the second item is his age, the third is his cholesterol. You can use the name operator to name the items. For example, the syntax pound sign name equals Bob assigns the string Bob to an item whose name is name. When you define a named list, you can use the name instead of an index to refer to items in the list. For example, $cholesterol refers to the third item in the list P. You can also use names in the sublist operator. In summary, SAS IML 14.3 contains new syntax that supports creating and manipulating lists. The new syntax enables you to create lists, extract items, extract sublists, and create lists that have named items. This new syntax makes it easier to perform common operations on lists. For a full description of the new syntax for lists, see the SAS IML 14.3 documentation. Thank you for listening. I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit about lists in SAS IML.